Hello everyone, welcome to Chitkara University. My name is Chef Deepak. Today we are going to discuss about commodities which we used in our hot kitchen as well as in bakery. So in this chapter we are going to cover fats and oil, rising agent, thickening agent and sugar. Specifically in this video we are going to discuss about fats and oil, which we call shortening also. So after completing this video, you should know what is fats and oils, varieties of shortenings, roles of shortenings in bakery, and advantages and disadvantages of using shortenings or using fats. So let's start. Shortening, any fat acts as a shortening in baking because it shortens gluten strands and tenderize the product. However, we generally use the word shortening to mean any of a group of solid fats, usually white and tasteless, that are specifically formulated for baking. Shortening generally consists of nearly 100% fat. The main objective of using shortenings in bakery is to shorten gluten strands and tenderize the product. If we would like to categorize shortening, we can categorize shortenings in three categories. The first one is regular shortening, the second one is high ratio plastic shortening, and the third one we have high ratio liquid shortening. Regular shortenings or all-purpose shortenings have a fairly tough, waxy texture, and small particles of the fat tend to hold the shape in a dough or batter. They are called plastic shortenings, which means they are moldable at room temperature. If we will talk about high ratio plastic shortenings, these are soft shortenings that spread easily throughout a batter and quickly coat the particles of sugar and flour. They are called high ratio because they were advised for use in cake batters that contain a high ratio of sugar and liquid to flour. Now we have high ratio liquid shortenings. High ratio liquid shortening, also called liquid cake shortening, are less hydrogenated than plastic shortening. So they are liquid and portable, although they are thick and cloudy in appearance. So if we talk about fats and oils and their varieties, we have saturated and unsaturated fats and oils. So what is saturation? Saturation means the density of fat. In other words, it is in the molecular structure of the fat where the carbon atoms are bonded with the oxygen and hydrogen. The saturation is increased artificially by adding hydrogen into fat by process known as a saturation or hydrogenation of oil. The oil is converted into margarine by passing hydrogen into it to make it saturated. This is done to stabilize the fats and oils, and therefore the shelf life of the product increased as it does not oxidize easily. Fats are naturally saturated with hydrogen, where some fats are artificially transformed from oil such as margarine. Such fats are known as a trans fats, and they are unhealthier as they are the prime cause of cardiac disorders. Furthermore, if we talk about fats, we have monosaturated and polysaturated fats. The type of fat you should eat, it's lower bad cholesterol and lowers the risk of heart disease and stroke. The other kind of fat which we have is saturated fat, which we have already discussed. Healthy source provide a pure concentrated source of energy. They act as a transporters for essential fat soluble vitamins A, D, E and K. You will get this fat from chicken, from beef. The other kind of fat which we have is hydrogenated oil and trans fats. We should avoid this kind of fat because दिस इज़ नॉट हेल्दियर सोर्स ऑफ फैट, इट इंक्रीजेज स्ट्रोक एंड हार्ट डिजीजेज. नाउ इट्स टाइम टू डिस्कस फैट्स विच वी यूज स्पेशली इन बेकरी. द फोर काइंड ऑफ फैट्स विच वी यूज इन बेकरी आर बटर, मार्जरीन, स्वेट एंड लार्ड. डेरी बटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ अबाउट 80% फैट एंड 20% वाटर एंड वी. इट इज़ द मिल्क प्रोटीन इन द वे दैट मेक्स बटर स्पॉइल क्विकली एंड टुगेदर विद मिल्क शुगर दैट इज लैक्टोज कॉज इट टू स्क्रॉच वेन ओवर हीटेड. इन द वेस्ट मोस्ट बटर इज मेड फ्रॉम काउज मिल्क बट एल्सवेयर बटर इज मेड फ्रॉम द मिल्क ऑफ वाटर बुफेलो, याक, गोट एंड शिप. Now, if we will talk about margarine, this is an emulsion of water and oil. It mainly contains vegetable oil, but at times it may contains a mixture of both animal and vegetable oils. These oils are then saturated by addition of hydrogen, which makes it more stable and increase its melting point. The handling of this fat becomes very easy in warm conditions, and it can be cream very well to give a more structure and volume to the baked product. Margarine is used mainly in pastry work and is hardly used in cooking. Fat from beef is called suet. Due to its stability, it used to be very common ingredient for short crust pie and other products. But butter has majorly replaced all the natural saturated animal fats. This is the fat from pork and is commonly used in cooking and baking. With more awareness of health, the use of lards and other natural animals' fat is restricted to special dishes only. Animal fats are rendered before using. Rendering is the process where the fats are heated on a low heat to remove the non-fatty membranes. The non-rendered fat has more pronounced flavor and it is commonly used to line pâtés and other charcuterie products. Now we will discuss about vegetables oils. These oils are also kind of fat. The first vegetable oil which we have is corn oil. It is made from corn or maize and has a smoke point of 230 degrees Celsius and is most suitable for deep frying. The other one which we have is cotton seed oil. Cotton seed oil is commonly used in cooking and it is also has a very high smoking point like corn oil. Sunflower oil. Most of the vegetables oil are made from seed and sunflower oil is no exception. Vegetables oil can be unrefined or refined. The refined process increases its smoking point, thereby making it more suitable for frying. It has a smoking point of 232 degrees Celsius. The other oil which we have is groundnut oil, also known as a peanut oil. It is suitable for deep frying as it has a high smoking point. People who are allergic to peanuts will not be affected by peanut oil as the proteins have the allergen and not the fats. It has a smoke point of 225 degrees Celsius. Palm oil. It is the most widely produced oil in the world. It is made from the seed of the fruit of the palm. It has a reddish hue because of the presence of the beta carotenes, which fade away when the oil is heated. It is very stable oil and hence commonly used to make margarine. The oil is semi-solid at room temperature. Now we have olive oil. It is made from olives and is commonly used in all the Mediterranean countries. This oil has a low smoking point of 165 degrees Celsius and hence not very suitable for deep frying. Mustard oil is made from mustard seed and is very common used in India. This oil is deep yellow in color and has a very strong flavor. Mustard oil should be allowed to smoke for at least 2 to 3 minutes to allow the pungent flavors to escape. This oil is commonly used to pickle vegetables. Now we will discuss about storage of fats.
All fats become rancid if exposed to the air too long. Also, they tend to absorb odor and flavors from other foods. Highly perishable fats such as butter should be stored well wrapped in the refrigerator. Other fats and oils should be kept in tightly closed containers in cool, dry and dark place.
So this is the end of the video. I hope you learned something new. In the next video, we are going to discuss about rising agent. Still, if you have any doubt about this video, you can comment in comment box or you can mail me at deepak.yadav@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.